Hey everybody, welcome back to the top of Skellige. Probably one of, well, it's not the highest, obviously, but it is one of the highest overlooks that we'll probably find. And it is gorgeous. Like, I love it here. It's outstanding. We are going to head towards Yennefer. We need to meet her at the site of this magic cataclysm, which she thinks has to do with Ciri, and there's a pretty good chance that that is going to be the case. On the way out, we're probably going to tackle a few things out in this area, which have piqued my interest. We've also got some notice boards down by Ranveig and whatever this town is. And there's multiple notice boards, but those ones are most certainly kind of on the way. So the last thing I'd like to do before I leave this upper area is go and see the armorers that we haven't met with yet. And I'm curious to see what they are all about. Are you serious, Roach? You can't be serious. No, he's serious. He's not moving.
Hey, yeah.
Okay. This is not good. Okay, I'll take that, actually.
Oi.
Sorry, my horse is blocking the way.
What's this?
Adornment. I engraved it.
Melt this blade and forge it again. A sword for cutting, not looking pretty.
I would argue that both could be done, actually. Let's go ahead and enhance our armor.
Greetings, White Wolf. I suspected you'd come by.
Bah! Oh, yeah.
I was sure of it.
Oh, yeah.
The best stocked armory in all Skellige is right here at Caer Trolde Castle. Everyone knows it.
I've heard some rumors.
See for myself.
Take your time. Give them all a careful look.
Okay. Hey, who do you think's going to be crowned king?
What do you think? Who will be the next king of the Isles?
Hjalmar, clear as day. Lad's brave and generous. And from Croc's own line. No better claimant.
Okay. Are you able to make master quality armor?
Looking for someone who can make me a master quality breastplate.
Never known a master who wasn't a dwarf.
Fergus, perhaps? Say he's holed up somewhere in Velen.
Oh. Fergus in Velen. Okay. Now, I don't know that we need anything crafted, but let's see what you have
Wouldn't
for
mind a
sale.
Look at your stock.
Okay, immediately I see maps. We have Witcher gear. Ibrahim Savi. Okay. More Witcher gear. Okay, so these are the second, third, and fourth maps, I think they were. Notes on Parchment by Hieronymus on Elgar the Witcher. Okay, we'll have to check those out in the quest items. What else is going on here? Cured Draconid leather he's got. That looks pretty cool. He's got just lead and some basic things, but yeah, he is definitely stocked. He's got a lot of glyphs. Hindarsfall heavy armor. He's got some pretty cool crafting diagrams here. Imperia brigade armor. You'll be able to craft this item after reading 20% sign intensity, 40% resistances. This must be heavy armor. It's a relic, so I don't know if it's classified any differently. Sounds like it's heavy armor for sure. I kind of want to buy these things just to have them, and then if we want to make them later, we can. I am going to go ahead and purchase this. The rest of them I think are probably cheap, but why not have the recipes? We have cash. Oh, that one was a bit expensive. Nilfgaardian Guardsman armor. Let's go ahead and just buy them anyways. These basic ones I don't think I will buy, like the glyphs. I don't think it's something that we're going to benefit from right now. But what I could do as well is get rid of some of our tunics, our Skellige shirt, and the rest I think we can keep. We'll sell the nice shoes, pants he can have, and I think that's good to go. We're very close. I hear within 24 hours of when I'm recording this that we're going to have patch 1.07. And that's a big deal for me because I've been holding on to a lot of stuff.
Craft something for me, will you?
In anticipation of that happening. So that's pretty cool. We are going to repair everything.
So long.
All right. Now, let's get out of here. Oh, here we go. We can sharpen our weapons. Beautiful. Now, the best way out of here, I guess, we just cross the bridge. We'll look into all of that armor down the road. Oh, you know what? This might be our best bet to get out of here, actually. Instead of just running. I think it's probably faster if we just jump down to here, and then we can exit from that location.
Axe? Are you serious?
Best blade's not worth shining.
Okay. Now, let's figure out kind of an idea of here of where we want to go. I am thinking maybe we run out to this side, and then we could swoop around here and check out this location, and we'll just go from there. I'm excited to explore this area. It's, as I've probably said about a million times now, I love it. This is probably the coolest thing I've experienced so far. And it, what I'm interested in, well, I'm not sure how much we're going to be able to make this happen. Whoa. Whoa. Hold on. What do we have happening here? Shield Maiden? What's this?
We serve her who is virgin, mother,
not something
and
I
crone.
Need.
What is it you wish?
Not much you can see through the fog. Roach, I need you to be
That's
very careful
Roach.
Up here. Okay, we've got some drowners here. Let's throw in some of our necrophage oil. Actually, I think, did I just goof on, let's see, are they necrophages, these guys? Yeah, drowners, okay, they fit. Now, what exactly are we looking for out here? It looks like it's up top, which is really intimidating, for one. But if we pay close enough attention, we might be able to find a way up there. Or maybe not. Okay, maybe if we head out here first, it looks like that's kind of a natural path to get up there, but truthfully, I think we might need to jump all the way around. I probably should have taken a closer look at that before, but since I'm not down with the topography of the area. Okay. I'm intrigued. Now, before we go any further, let's check these maps that we have here. So here's the, okay, this is the first map, the third, and the fourth. So the first one, after the discovery of marks relating to the Bear School of Witchers in the ruins of Castle, I think they call it Twirseek. Professor Adamstein sent me to prepare a map similar to the one prepared by A. Kermith, indicating the various locations of the archipelago where these symbols occur. Professor Adamstein was, of course, correct in his suspicions. I quickly found such locations and have marked them on my map. Okay, beautiful. Third map, I'm charting a direct course for the spot where we commenced our study, the ruins of Castle Tuirseek, or Tuirseech. As I travel, I've been marking the additional locations with the bear symbol, which I've discovered. He's still following me. The map is damaged and covered in blood, hard to decipher which locations are marked, and only a portion of the text is legible. In the ruins of Castle Tuirseek, that is where we made our first findings. I shall be there, bloodstains, this portion covered in blood. Ibrahim Savi. Okay. And this note on parchment. Some of the improvements to the School of the Wolf gear are hidden in the Skellige Isles. Elgar left them in the central part of Ard Skellig and in the ruins of two watchtowers, one in Unvik and one in Spikerug. He wanted them to be available for witchers who need them and are clever enough to find them. Okay, so that's something to take a look at later.
Bad idea.
Bastard!
Watch the barrel! Oh, I can feel that coming. I think that did more damage to me than it did them. Yeah, I'm gonna need to get the swallow going, like, now. I think any closer to that barrel, and we are absolutely dead right at this moment. There we go, gentlemen. There we go. I'll take that. And you know what? Because it's just gonna weigh us down, we don't need the axe. Oh, look at the symbols. Look at the symbols. Okay. I'm intrigued. Oh, there we go. Take a very direct path here. I have a feeling I might know what's here, actually. Now that I can get a closer look at the location. I feel like this would be a great place to have a place of power. However. We got something glowing. Not a place of power. Merbor sword, Magdira cuirass. Okay. Whoa! Oh, that was really. That was some Smash Brothers right there. That could have been instant death. And by instant, I mean slow, really drawn out death by falling from 1,000 feet in the air. Really happy that that did not just take place. Now, we do have this out here, but we can go and grab that later on. I think I want to check out this area up to the north. Where's Roach? Oh, there we go. Come on, girl. There will definitely come a time when I fall off one of these cliffs. I can almost guarantee that. I'm not looking forward to it. Ah! Like, it's so dense in here, it's almost intimidating. These are not like the forests that we are used to, that's for sure. And with all the mountains and everything kind of blocking any direct path, we're gonna have to get maybe a bit creative here with how we get places. Like, I'm not seeing how we would get out there. We're probably best off traveling to these little towns and then going in, because this is all mountain range, right? So I think that's what I'll do.
Want to keep an eye on him. No such thing as bad ships.
Yeah, let's go down here to Renveg. We can check the notice board there as well. That might even give us some additional things to do on the way.
Remember last year?
Okay, so Freya calling. God-fearing and industrious unmarried women who would like to spend the rest of their lives serving the goddess are invited. Glory to Eldred. The Council of Elders has decreed that for spotting the pirates who in the dead of night were trying to break upon the village, or sneak upon the village, sorry, and for chasing them back to their boats with a hot fire iron in her hand, Eldra the Brave to be rewarded 10 sheepskins and a barrel of the finest mead. The white male is mine. If you see a white... Oh, white whale. If you see a white whale in the sea, let it swim on. It's mine. If anyone catches it before me, Freya be my witness, I will stab that wretch to death with my harpoon. That's a Moby Dick reference. The patricide's execution. Otter the Bold was pronounced guilty of murdering his own father by the Council of Elders. He will be punished as the laws demand for such a crime. He will be burnt with fire, then flayed, then sewn in a sack together with a cat, a dog, and a snake. Finally, the sack will be thrown into the sea. That seems excessive. Nithing. I'm asking for help for anyone who can give it. Someone has cast a cruel and treacherous curse on my line for which I cannot find a remedy. If you skill in undoing such charms, or even if you have heard of a worthy cunning man or peller who has such a gift, seek out my house near Renveg and rescue me from this misfortune. I shan't spare the coin in recompense. Contract missing son, be ye Skelliger or continent man, read attentively and to the very end. My son Olf, you went off to seek adventure and never returned, so I'm asking all travelers to keep their eyes out for him. And if you bring him back or find out what's happened to him, I'll pay a generous reward and keep you in my prayers, Freya. Alright. So that being said, looks like we have some horse races here. Talk to Lothar, it's very close by. Missing son. Okay, that might be a little bit out of our comfort zone, potentially. So let's look for this one. He was looking for a peller, but we've got a few skills he might be interested in. He's got a pretty nice setup here. Hey, what's going on with this? Okay. Well, that might come in handy after we talk to him, perhaps.
Have mercy. Who'll I leave my home to if Chalva dies? Who'll continue my line?
Mind if I interrupt?
Nay. My prayers are in vain anyways.
Have you been having trouble with the curse? You're the one, right?
Here you're having trouble with the curse.
I am. Look. See it lying there? The horse head on the pole? That's...
A knife.
Yeah, I noticed it.
Kind of curse. Seen this before. They're nothing to scoff at. Can bring misfortune, even death.
Aye. And the name carved upon it is Tialva, my firstborn. Boy's feverish, grows weaker by the day. I fear I'll bury him before the next moon. Tried to lift the curse myself, but no luck.
Look, I know I can help you.
I can help you, one of two ways. First, I can try to convince whoever put up the Nithing to lift the curse themselves. Second, I can deflect the curse back on whoever cast it by writing their name on the shaft. Either way, Need to know okay. who's behind this.
A little revenge but curse.
I don't trouble no one. Don't know a soul who'd wish it upon me.
Mm-hmm. Guess I gotta investigate.
That was my first question, is who did he wrong? And I guess we're gonna start by checking this thing out a little bit closer.
A knithing, a powerful curse. Name carved on the shaft. Tjalve, son of Lothar, trails fresh. Might wanna look around some.
Little did they know he would hire a witcher for this. What's with there's wild horses out there? Is that what that is?
What is this? Woman's shawl.
Mm-hmm.
Distinctive pattern. Distinctive
Lothar.
Smell.
Any ideas who this woman could be? Jeez. It's not light for wildlife, that's for sure.
Too many scents. Can't follow my nose any further. Need to ask around about the shawl.
Okay, I don't suppose the guards would know. They're usually not too interested in helping out anyways. What about, what if we ask this individual? Oh, not these guys. I meant to ask the alchemist, but...
Greetings.
Greetings.
Okay, no.
See ya.
Fare thee well.
Nice to see you.
These continental dandies come a-strutting, then we gotta drag their corpses out of the inn.
Well, they're all guards as far as what I can tell. It? Except for maybe this guy. No. Here, Odin.
You, Odin?
Odin.
I am.
Oh, this is the other guy. You know what, Odin? I'm gonna come back, okay?
Sorry, can't take this on right now. Farewell.
I definitely will. It's just a matter of time.
A witcher, eh?
Somebody, here
Aye?
We go.
What did you need?
Do you recognize this shawl?
Any chance you know who wore this shawl?
Probably her.
Of course. Yona, our herbalist, lives there in that hut. Oh, she'll be pleased you found it for her.
Yeah, real pleased.
Yeah, wood grains. Amazing. Okay, so we were just there. Oh,
I recognize
where are you going?
Your type.
Found your shawl near Lothar's house by the knithing you put up there.
Anything you want to explain?
How did you know?
Had a hunch. Thanks for confirming it. You know Tjalva's got one foot in the grave?
Good. That bastard should never have
Whoa.
Been born.
Why?
Me, I was to be Lothar's bride. But he cast me aside for that flounder.
Oh, yeah.
Getting his comeuppance now. Him and that whole plowing family.
You think that's fair? Yeah, like...
You'd kill a child out of jealousy? Are you serious?
It is not jealousy, but dignity that matters here. 10 years we lived side by side. 10 years I cooked for him, washed his breeches, shared me bed. And he abandoned me with nary a word. Whole village laughed. Stupid Bint Yona let herself be had. No, I have not been had, nor have I forgot.
Look, obviously she was caught off guard when he left her. But to go and really kill a child because of that, like, that's not... you can't wrap your head around that.
Want you to lift the curse. I mean it.
Fine, I'll do it. But I've my terms. Lothar's to renounce his son and come
back
to me.
That's not gonna happen.
I'll be sure to tell him. but I think we both know what his answer will be.
That is not gonna happen at all. Like, now, we're gonna have to make a decision here. Do we redirect the curse back at her? I don't know that I want to be doing that either, because that's getting a little bit too involved for my personal tastes. But, let's see. Let's see what happens here.
So, you know who placed the knifing?
I do. It's your old friend, Yona.
Old friend of yours, Yona.
I might have guessed. Jealous bitch! Can't stand to see others happy. So, will she lift the curse?
Yeah, sure. All you gotta do is renounce your family and go back to her.
Nay, never! My wife, my son, I'd strip them of honor. Condemn them to poverty. You've gotta break the spell, Witcher. Let her die!
My god. So, okay. Of course, the choice comes down to us. Do we let the boy die? Actually, we don't even have that choice. It's either we reflect it back to her, or he leaves his family and goes back to this crazy whatever. She's willing to kill a boy because of what? Because she had an affair or something? Like, or maybe, I don't know if this happened. It's interesting, actually. That could be the fact that maybe he was having an affair with her and she pulled crazy. Or maybe he was with her and then he left her and started this family or whatever. That's kind of interesting. Could go either way. But regardless, she's crazy and she's willing to kill a boy for what? Like, get over it. I don't think so. She does have a lot of herbs and stuff that maybe we might need, but I'm pretty sure we can find stuff elsewhere. And the fact that she's willing to kill this boy, yeah, no, we're gonna do this. This is a
you
tough call, but...
You might deserve to be punished, but not this way. Fine, I'll do it.
Thanks be to the gods.
Don't bring the gods into it. This is between two human beings.
Yeah, well, this is a tough call, but I... Of the lesser evils.
A-O-N-N-A. May it be quick and painless.
It's done, Lothar.
So? Did it work?
It did. Your son should recover soon. And Yona will die.
Thanks, Witcher. 1,000 times over. My son's dearest of all to me. I couldn't abide it if he died.
I understand that.
Your reward. Will you eat with us before moving onward?
No. Not in the mood.
Yeah, not exactly.
There's truth to that blather by the ice giant.
That's pretty crazy. Oh, look, there's the boy. Well, look, he's gonna get better, at least. That's a tough one about Yona, but what can you do in that kind of scenario, you know? That's insane. Let's head towards Yennefer. We've got, these couple locations along the way, so that it makes sense to go and grab those. Man, that's tough. I don't like that. Shouldn't have to make those choices. I don't see an alternative way that we could have solved that, but... Let's throw our Hangman's Venom on here and see if we can't... Whack away our... Damn it. Whack away our problems.
Damn, you're ugly.
There we go. Let's go, big boy. What's going on here? Oh, we're probably liberating. Or we're not. Okay, cool. Good thing they all brought sandwiches to work. Okay, that wasn't too crazy. And this will take us to another small little settlement, it looks like. Come on over here, Roach. Let's ride down by the water. Well, it's not gonna last us that long. You can do this, Roachy baby. There you go. Oh, look, they got a nice little operation. Oops. Nice little operation going here. Ooh, is this what I think it is? Well, not exactly. Wait a second here. It's down below. Oh, we're going into a crypt? You know what that means. Yep. Oh, God. They are big as well.
Come on, come closer.
Whoa. Okay, first thing, Spectre Oil. Let's go, let's go. Spectre, 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 Spectre. There it is. Definitely could have went poorly. What is it that you're protecting down here, ladies? I don't know why I assume they're all ladies. Bellhaven Brigandine Relic. Hi there. Okay, nothing too fantastic compared to what we have. Now, I have a strange feeling that I'm going to need to be getting our fiend decoction going quite soon. Let's head into this town here of an unknown name.
Gideon.
I honestly thought that little rock at the top was going to be a place of power. Alas, I was wrong.
Tend to your own problems.
Hey!
Watchet!
Blandair. Okay.
Karak, it's about what they're to sell first. Except they've not got a full guard.
So what do we have here? About Hjordis, many a young man have asked me to give my Hjordis as wife. To all of them, I say the same thing. Hjordis will take the one she herself chooses, and I will not go against her wishes. Go talk to her if you like and leave me in peace. Looking to buy a ram's head. Anybody selling a ram's head? Need one for eel bait. Council of Elders decision. They have decided as follows. If one rents a mare and the mare foals, the foal is the owner's property. But the one to whom the stallion belongs has the right to half a pail of milk for as long as the mare is producing milk. That seems fair. An omen, perhaps. I caught a two-headed cod yesterday. Is it a sign from gods? Or I don't know whether to start it smoking or take it to the druid so they can have a look at it. Go plow somewhere else. To the couple boffing in my barn every night, ride the crupper somewhere else. I've had enough of that noise. Next time I'll chase you out with a whip. And contract missing miners. It'll not come to as news to most, but let me repeat for the ignorant. A few of our lads went looking for ore in the mountains and never returned. They must have run into trouble, and since the brave warriors couldn't handle it themselves, it must have been serious trouble indeed. That's why I'm looking for a brave man to go up and suss out what's become of them. Whoever does so will get gold to match his glory.
Vagrant.
That's cool.
Okay.
We do have a merchant here.
Not expecting anyone to strike from the sea.
Would very well be your lucky day.
Spending hard-earned coin, that's an art in itself.
Yeah, I'm good at it, too. Very good at it. Oh, Gwinter.
Let me have a look.
Let's see. The Lonesome World Guide to Anskellige. Read this guidebook to unlock fast travel points. Okay. Other than that, though, I mean, it's not really anything that I'm interested in. You can just take everything that we have that doesn't look cool. Oh, nope. Well, that's the shawl that we had. I'm gonna keep it. The cone, I'll keep all that stuff.
So long.
All right. I would love to play him in a game, but we'll probably save that for another time. And now, I think we're actually quite close to Yen. So, let's see. Let's head down here. Probably just run over. Oh. I'm one to hear offers,
what's this
yes.
offer? Got a contract for me?
Might do. If you're willing to partner with me.
Usually work alone.
Could pay to make an exception this time. It's not every day you get a chance to work with the most renowned bounty hunter north
of the Yaruga. Oh, Jenga Fret!
Jenga Fret himself!
Hey! That's cool.
I'll bite. What's the famous Jenga Fret need a witcher for?
I'm guessing you're a man of the world. Perhaps you've come across the Grossbart brothers in your travels.
The Grossbart
you
brothers?
You hunting them?
Aye. Quite the rogues they are. Three of them. And everyone's got a pack of rapes and murders under his belt. Even took to grave robbing lately. Easy to recognize on account of the yellow caps they wear. Folks see three yellow tops, they flee to their huts. Which don't help much, of course. Because they're also fond of arson.
No, haven't met him.
If you do, tread careful. They're quick to stick a knife in a man's gut. Often just by way of greeting.
Okay.
Doubt they'd try that with a witcher.
You never know with that lot. Right, well I head south soon. Haven't looked there yet. Fare you well. We might meet again someday.
Oh. Sad tale of the Grossbart brothers. So that's that seems interesting. I'm intrigued, definitely.
Best blade's not worth
we'll definitely keep our eye out. The three yellow caps, and obviously if we do run into them somewhere, don't trust them.
Right. I'll take half.
On account of what he said. Jenga Fret, though, we've read about him in the past, I believe, and pretty renowned, so it's kind of cool that we'd run into him here. I wonder if he's somebody we see again later. Itinerant merchant's note, small chest key. Freya be praised. Read the note. Praise be to Freya, our great mother. They said the road was fraught with danger, that sea devils awaited any who traveled it, that a bandit lurked behind every tree. But I sacrificed a lamb to Freya and donned an amulet made of falcon feathers, and lo and behold, I traversed the entire isle without so much as drawing my sword, and did some damn fine trading along the way. Packed my chest so full of silver and other treasures that my back near snapped, setting it on the wagon. If everything goes as planned, I'll be home by tomorrow around sunset. I owe the goddess mightily for the tender care she's taken of me. Yeah, of course it's going to be surrounded. Come on. Now, what I do need to do is get our necrophage oil going. Where is it? All of a sudden, we got a weird sorting thing going on here.
Come on, come closer.
That'll do. Huh, okay. figured we wouldn't have too many problems with them, but... Oh, I've got it. Gold Pearl Necklace, Gold Casket, Melitele Figurine, and Diable. Well, you don't say. It looks cool, that's for sure. All right, and with that, I think it's time to go and see Yen.
Go, go.
Let's find a path here. Here we go.
Clear on the other side of the island.
Good! May all Skellige know, Jennifer of Vengerberg is a common thief!
Okay, let's
cool
it.
Control yourself, Druid. I haven't stolen anything. I've merely borrowed something and fully intend to return it.
Ha! The generosity! Just one small problem. Once used, the mask is rendered completely worthless. Not to mention the risk you'll bury us alive, and all the Isles with us!
Barry, what are you talking about?
She's not told you? Might have expected as much. The myth is that Urbarus created the mask when the envious seas swallowed his beloved. Unable to bear the prospect that he would never again see his betrothed, Urbarus made the mask, which would allow him to peer into the past. He knew, however, that he could only use it once. So he waited. Waited until his longing grew so strong that it became unbearable. When the sea learnt of the mask, it was quick to respond. It made known its threat that whosoever used the mask would bring the sea's wrath down on them. For in vengeance, the sea would rise and flood all the lands and drown the living.
And nobody's ever used it, you're sure? How did you get your hands on it?
Where do you get this mask?
Sailors from Clan Dimmon pulled it from the sea, near the Njord Trench.
Yeah, but how can you be sure this is Urbaros's mask?
Its appearance is exactly as described in the myths.
Yeah, but how
you
descriptive?
The myths.
Only
can you describe a mask?
Fools belittle their significance. Besides, it's not the myths that are on trial here. It's the thief.
I don't know if Croc's permission is going to make a big difference to him.
On the one hand, a theft. On the other, Ciri's life.
I also care deeply for the girl. I proposed a series of other methods. Yennefer refused to listen. She claimed they would take too long. For as she wants, she needs immediate results.
I mean,
she has
we do
always
need them.
Been hot-headed.
True. At least this time she's got a valid reason for it.
Never mind that she might bring...
Whoa!
What was that? No. Yennefer's used the mask.
She would. Yes, she would. Okay, let's just see. Oh, we've got a place of power just sitting here.
Vendalion's humming. The place of power, it's gotta be.
There we go. Let's move. that Ermion running through here? No, that's Yolar. Okay. This is Ermion. Yen, oh god.
Great.
Whoa. Got your back.
I learned this.
There we go.
What was that?
Unicorns.
Damn it, Yen. I saw the foglets. I meant how'd they get here.
The power of the mask summoned them.
Yeah, I see that. Ermion's not very happy.
Ermion says the mask might cause a natural disaster.
Fortunate he's here, then. He can jump right in, try to tame it.
Realize he won't let this pass.
Oh, I'll survive, somehow.
What now?
The mask reveals the past, but only in certain places. Places where past events left a strong magical imprint. Take it.
Like, obviously, where...
Want me to wear it?
Yes. I'll cast a spell that will let me see through your eyes.
Whoa.
Gonna read my mind again?
You object?
No, it's fine.
You do it whenever you want, anyway.
No harm in it, then, is there? Let's go. Already found the first spot.
Here we go. Okay. So, let's get it going here. Let's throw the mask on. One quick thing I'm gonna do. Oh, I can't do it from here, but. I was going to suggest that she wear something a little bit more in line with what's going on here, but I'll do that later.
Yes? This is the spot.
What
is-
oh.
Any instructions?
Keep it on until we've seen everything. And don't stray far. Telepathy is limited in range.
What's that? A portal?
Two people emerged from it.
The woman was Ciri.
How can you know?
The way she moved. Like a witcher. Seems they went that way.
Come, let's find the next spot.
Oh no! Is she okay? Okay, they didn't attack her.
Well, ready?
I am.
Use the...
Okay, there was a battle.
Watch out!
Whoa.
What was that?
A magic explosion of some sort. So powerful that even the echo was dangerous.
Oh, so this is the
epicenter.
I wager
it destroyed the forest.
But Ciri and her companion weren't harmed. I saw them escape.
Let's see where to.
Place is creepy. I don't like it.
Nor do I.
Anyone here when this happened had a slim chance of surviving.
I know what you're thinking, but don't worry. Ciri can take care of herself.
That's that!
Oh, come on!
Chased Ciri. See that? Might have wounded her.
She escaped through another portal.
Know where it led?
Magic residue trail leads to Velen.
Any chance you can figure out where Ciri's companion fled to? His portal's gotta be nearby.
I'll try to find it. Come.
Okay. There we go, we can see something.
Nice nice fight.
One repelled the other with powerful magic, then fled through a portal.
A mage?
Most likely. It's Ciri's companion and the one who wounded her.
How do you know?
I don't. Making an educated guess. They both appeared in the previous visions.
Ciri's got a powerful ally.
Could be...
The mage who was with Ciri fled too. Nowhere?
His trace path leads to Velen as well. But the target coordinates of his portal differ from those of Ciri's. The explosion must have disrupted his teleportation.
Ran into Kira Metz and Velen. Coincidence maybe, but...
I don't believe in coincidences.
She claimed a mage came to her looking for Ciri.
Exactly.
Be surprised if it wasn't the same one.
Whoever he is, he grows more interesting by the minute.
No, it's gotta be the same one.
Maybe something left of the one who got hit by the spell.
It's clearing up.
Ermion must be getting a handle on the weather.
Which means he'll be free to attack us again.
Are you pleased with yourselves? Look at what you've brought down on us! If someone's death were to help you find Ciri, would you start making human sacrifices as well?
Relax. Storm's died down. You've clearly got things under control.
For now. But who knows what will be a week or two on?
Stop panicking. Here's your mask.
It is worthless. It's an unwieldy ashtray at best. I hope you've learned something useful at least.
Very.
I'm talking to Geralt. You. You I'll deal with later. So?
We did learn something.
We think a powerful curse was cast here.
Plausible. Considering what happened to the wood.
Confirms
you know
a lot of our suspicions.
Whom?
Not yet. But we know Ciri was here. She stepped out of a portal. A mage was with her. Someone chased them. They fought. Ciri was wounded but managed to escape.
Where to?
Velen, probably. The mage opened a portal for her. Then he fought her attacker.
Yes? Is that it?
Well, we just need to examine one more trail.
Got a feeling we've found something interesting. Just need to examine one more thing.
He went flying in that direction.
Let's look for a body then.
Something's pinned under that tree. Can you...
I can. Geralt, please move before I first place Gary Rockwood.
Is clean. No blood, no sword nicks. Ciri's friend must have... What do you call it?
Disintegrated.
Or vaporized.
Exquisite. The armor. Though the workmanship's unfamiliar. Can't even tell where it's from.
Probably because it belonged to a rider of the Wild Hunt.
What? So it's true? The Wild Hunt? I feared as much. First here, then on Hindersfjall. What did they want?
They're looking for Ciri.
But why?
They're more than looking.
Elder blood flows in Ciri's veins.
Tis true, she can trace her lineage clear back to Lara Doran, which is why the women in her family have always had extraordinary abilities. But could that truly be so important?
Of course it could be.
She travels between places here and other worlds. Space is no obstacle for her.
Huh?
Which is why the Wild Hunt wants to capture her.
Imagine what they could do with that power. You said they were in Hindersfjall?
Speaking of the hunt, mentioned it appeared on Hindersfjall.
Well, it happened at least a fortnight after the cataclysm struck here on Ard Skellig. The raids raided Lothotan at dusk.
That's no coincidence.
Itself a strange occurrence for that time of year. The islanders said the wraiths. They barged into their huts, killed anyone who resisted, then galloped inland, laughing fiendishly.
Anyone survive?
A dozen or so women,
and an old man.
Next stop, Indosfjall.
I'll meet you on the beach near Lofoten.
Okay. I'll meet you there.
Mm-hmm. See you there.
Good luck to you. Inform me once you've learned anything new.
Okay, so that's confirmed a lot of things that we thought about Ciri. Definitely traces back to Velen and references the mage that we learned about a long time ago. So yeah, this is heating up for sure. This is definitely heating up. I'm thinking we're probably going to continue to try and work with Yennefer here. This is going to take us across here to this island. And along the way, we could probably clear out this top area here. And then we could cross. We have the boat. Maybe we do these three. We grab the boat, head out here, grab these, and then head across and talk to Yen. I'm thinking that's a good game plan. But thank you guys very much for watching. We're going to see you next time, and take care of yourselves. Goodbye.